What's up, YouTube? I want to show and review these hoodies I have from John Elliott. I have two cake mock pullover hoodies, one in gray and one in black, and one raglan hoodie in this beige slash tan colorway. Let's review these hoodies, do a little comparison, and then talk about the pros and cons of each of these. Let's start with the cake mock hoodies. This cake mock hoodie here is a nice heathered gray colorway when you look up close. The primary features that make these cake mock hoodies unique is the slightly oversized fit, as well as this triangular collar in front of the neck area. With the slightly oversized fit, there is a slight dropped shoulder, but as long as you size correctly, the dropped shoulder should not compromise the length of the entire sleeve. But I'm gonna get into the sizing later in the video. This hoodie came with cream colored drawstrings, which is a nice touch, but the tips came raw like this and become even more worn and more raw with prolonged wear and tear. I wish there was an aglet to keep this in place for a cleaner look. This hoodie is lined with French terry inside, which I love because this material is great for sufficiently keeping you warm and it does not seem to attract any static, unlike fleece. It's also a reasonable weight in its entirety, not too heavy but not too light either. Of course, like many other hoodies, you have the classic kangaroo pocket, and moving to the sides, there is an elastic ribbing for a little more waist room and flexibility. And then moving down to the bottom of the hoodie is a very slight dropped hem on the back. Otherwise, everything else about this hoodie is quite basic and essential, with the monochromatic heather gray colorway throughout and no logos or branding in sight externally. So I actually like this hoodie so much that I had to get a second one. Here's the black one, but this one came with aglets on the drawstrings. And otherwise, it's just a simple colorway with the monochromatic black throughout. Let's move on to the raglan hoodie for a little bit. The raglan hoodie is another one of John Elliott's signature silhouettes, but of course there are some main differences between this one and the cake mock hoodies. Let's take a look at some of the details here. The raglan hoodie is more quote-unquote basic or classic, so there's no triangular collar. The front of the hood has a small overlap to give the base of the hood just a little more standing structure. The silhouette of the raglan hoodie is a little more relaxed rather than oversized, so the shoulders actually sit more normally without the drop shoulder. Another note to mention is that these hoodies do not have drawstrings. I find the distal end of my sleeves to have a little more room towards the wrists in my raglan hoodie compared to the cake mocks. This hoodie also has kangaroo pockets, and moving down to the bottom, it has a single ribbed waistband with no dropped hem. This hoodie also has French terry lining inside. Again, this is a basic and essential hoodie in a monochromatic colorway with no branding and with more of a relaxed fit. Let's talk about sizing. I actually sized down on the cake mock hoodies because they're marketed as oversized fits, and I'm glad I did. I'm normally a size medium, but with these, I am wearing a size small. As mentioned, these hoodies come with a slight drop shoulder, but because I sized down, this was perfect for my sleeve length. The torso might be sitting a little higher than I like, but I'm probably wearing a longer t-shirt underneath anyways, so it works out for me. I also don't like things too oversized on me, and so again, by sizing down, this worked perfectly. For the raglan hoodie, I am wearing a size medium, which is my true size. For reference, I am 5'8 and 155 pounds, and as I mentioned earlier, the end of the sleeves were a little too roomy for my liking. I might get these sleeves tailored a little bit more narrow, but otherwise, I love the quality and colorway of this beige hoodie. With these John Elliott hoodies, I love them all because they're great for wearing alone by itself, but also, they can be great for layering. The possibilities for styling these are endless. Some examples of how I wear these hoodies are underneath bomber jackets, denim jackets, utility jackets, flannels, or vests, just to name a few. I feel like the cake mock hoodie specifically pioneered the way for a lot of streetwear brands to mimic that boxy, dropped shoulder hoodie aesthetic with the high collar, but John Elliott was still able to execute this in a tasteful, men's fashion way. I'd love to get even more colorways of these, but the biggest downside of these hoodies is the price. I can't justify paying over $150 for a basic essential hoodie, let alone multiple pieces of them. You're pretty much paying for the iconic silhouette, as well as some pretty decent quality, But again, for an essential monochromatic hoodie, I'm sure there are much cheaper alternatives. At the time of making this video, John Elliott is having a 25% off some signature pieces on their website, with goals of donating some of the profits towards UCLA health research and education, so now's a great time to cop some essentials. Let me know what you think of John Elliott essentials. Is paying triple digits for a hoodie overkill? Are there any other brands that can compete with these John Elliott essential hoodies? I'd love to hear about it. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe. I'll be posting more videos on sneaker reviews, clothing reviews, and performance reviews. And while you're here, consider checking out my Stone Island and my Amy Leon Dore reviews here and here. I'm also open to recommendations if you have products or brands you want me to review and check out. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace.